Nowadays, I've been getting a lot of requests about how to prepare for bank interviews. Whether you are writing or going for an interview for SEBI, RBI, NABARD, SBI, IBPS, RRB, or any other banking examination, there are some basic tips that you need to remember before you start your preparation for the interview. In order to understand how to prepare better and how to be able to score higher in an interview, it's important to understand what the examiner or the interviewer wants from you. The examiner wants two basic things in a banking interview. The first is he wants to understand how well you know about yourself and whatever you have mentioned in your biodata form. And the second element is the sync between what his organization wants from you and what you know. The better the sync is between what he wants from you and what you know, the higher the chances that you will get selected. So let's start understanding both these elements one by one. The first element, as I said, is things about you. For example, your biodata will contain the region that you belong to, number one. Secondly, the education that you have attained. Number three, hobbies that you have. Number four, work experience. These are the four major things. So it's important that you have some questions already made and you have read a little about the region that you belong to. They might ask you questions connecting your region, let's say the type of soil, the rural areas in your region, the banking penetration in your region, so on and so forth. So create a list of questions about things related to your region. The second is education, very, very important. Now we divide education into two, three parts. So first one is, let's say you are a commerce student. Because banking is so strongly connected with commerce, so it's important that you are very thoroughly prepared about basic concepts and analytical things related to commerce. Let's say they ask you what are intangible assets, some examples of intangible assets, what are NBFCs, what are hedge funds, what is a call option, what is a put option, what are swaps, what are options, what are derivatives. They might ask you all these kinds of things and they expect that you know them because you belong to a commerce background. On the other hand, there are a lot of students who are either engineers or have BTech background or science background, doctors or students who are from arts background. They certainly don't expect a lot from you when it comes to your education. There are two reasons behind that. Number one, it is not going to help them in their job. If you're selected as a banker, your understanding about science or arts is not going to be very helpful. IT will be, but not otherwise. And the second is they themselves are not experts in the field of science or arts. Therefore, there is a very smaller, horizon or smaller capability for them to ask you questions related to those areas. Yes, if you belong to the IT background, then they will and they can ask you questions related to IT and its connection with banking. Now, we are done with education, so you have to create some questions from your educational background also, and you should be very clear about your education. The third is hobbies. It's very important that you stay very positive and very honest when you're writing about your hobbies and when you're discussing the same in the interview room. It's important that you do not lie when it comes to your hobbies because they expect that you're very highly committed with your hobby, number one, and that you know all the theoretical aspects related to your hobbies. So create a list of questions related to hobbies as well in advance. For example, my hobby is playing ukulele. So if I go in for the interview tomorrow, I have to be certain that I know every basic detail about ukulele, all the important singers or famous personalities related to ukulele, the history of uke, and I understand where all it is played and what are the playing basics, what are the different chords, what are the different styles of playing, what are the different sizes of ukes. So all those things should be very clear in my head before I go in for the interview. The third was hobbies. The fourth one is work ex. If you have worked in the banking sector or the financial sector or any sector related to banking or accounting or finance, then you can expect some questions from those areas. However, if your work ex has been in the field of, let's say, IT or science or medicine or arts or anything which does not have a strong connection with banking, then they might not ask you questions from those areas. So this is about you, the first element. The second element is about the organization and it sync with what you know. Okay, so what the examination needs or what the organization needs is a good understanding from you related to broad areas of banking. What are the NPA levels? What are Basel norms? What are different ratios which are used in risk management for banks? Your views on privatization of banking. So everything and anything which is under the umbrella of banking, the basic terms and concepts, you should be aware about them. There are very good books which are available on Amazon regarding banking interviews. They are specifically made for people who are applying for promotions and interviews. So you can buy them and you can use those to revise all the basic banking concepts. The second thing that they might ask you in the banking, what they're looking for is leadership qualities and honesty. Okay, so these are very theoretical and intangible things that they're often looking for. So it's important that you remain upright, you maintain your integrity, you remain very, very honest and very committed as to why are you coming for the interview and why do you want to join the organization. Because no matter how good you are when it comes to your intellect, knowledge and your background, if they feel that you're not honest, that you might not be committed or you might, indulge into frauds or anything like that in the future, even if they get a hint, they will reject you outrightly. So it's very important that you work on this, that as well. Now, how do you work on these two elements? That is our last and the most important topic to discuss. We have understood what exactly are they looking for, what are the different areas, and I hope you've written it down. How do you prepare for it? The best way to prepare for it is to think like an interviewer and interviewee on a regular basis once you're preparing for interviews. Okay, so let's say I want to understand, okay, what are the questions the examiner can ask from Basel norms? Okay, let's start thinking like an interviewer. So the interviewer will ask, okay, briefly tell me about the history of Basel in the world. Okay, that is one question. Briefly tell me about the evolution of Basel norms since Basel 1. Okay, that is one question. Can you tell me about Basel 3 and what are the broad targets? One factual question. Can you tell me about India's achievement in Basel 3? What all have we already achieved and what are the pending tasks? Another question. Can you tell me what are the targets that we have skipped or targets that we have postponed because of COVID in Basel? Another question. Do you think that the Basel targets are good enough or are we leaving anything? Another question. What are the specific Basel 3 norms and additions made in Basel 3 in comparison with Basel 2? Another question. So I'm creating as many questions as possible by thinking like an interviewer. Create a list of 30-40 questions from one topic and keep exploring as many questions as you can create and then move forward to the next topic. This way, you will be able to create a list of 1,000, 1,500 questions. And once you do that, you're increasing your probability of, getting those questions which you already prepared in the examination hall, in the interview room. And that is your sole objective, to improve or increase your probability of finding questions in the interview room which you've already prepared. So this exactly is the entire idea of how to prepare for bank interviews, and I'm very, very sure after this session you will be more clear about how to prepare, and specifically students who are going to give interviews for RBI and SEBI very soon will be helped by this session. All the best, guys. Take care. Bye bye.